Whether you are a prospective customer or a current customer of a eufyMake UV printer, you're going to find out, or you already know, that a natural byproduct of UV resin printing is fumes, smells. The weird plastic stuff, it sticks around whether the machine runs or not. If you are like me, my wife, or my kids, or my other family who's come in my shop, you will smell it right away when you walk in, whether the machine's running or not. For me personally, it gives me headaches. My wife has headaches as well from this. And so today's video is showing you a solution that I put into place. Number one, for my necessity to continue to use the machine and for the safety of my family. But for number two, to show you guys what it's like to install my Samcraft eufyMake Fume Extractor, install it and everything, but also show you a really cool product available from Amazon to ventilate this through a window. That's right. You don't have to drill holes through your walls or floors anymore. You don't necessarily have to buy an expensive air purifying machine. You can just put it through the window for about 30 bucks. What's up guys, Sam here and welcome back to Samcraft. Today, of course, UV printer. But you may be wondering or thinking, oh man, I missed Sam's video about this machine. Well, it's not been put out yet because this was step one, overcoming this hurdle to allow me to use the machine in my shop. Very, very soon after this though, will be my full video on this machine. I've been using it for over 2 months now, so it's not an unboxing and looky-loo. This is a full deep dive, giving you a lot of information that I've learned, good, bad, wonderful, ugly, that'll all be in that video coming up very, very soon. In fact, look down below if you're here from the future, there should be a link to it. You can click onto it after you watch this one. Otherwise, let's jump into this video's project for today, which is ventilating that guy out of the shop. The first thing that I'm going to install is this kit that I purchased off of Amazon. It is a window kit for ventilation. It will allow me to install my exhaust port from the UV printer through my window and not have to drill holes in my workshop, my space, and give me the versatility to move this around as I need to. This particular kit was pretty affordable. It was under 30 bucks off of Amazon. It consists of several PVC panels. They slide, they lock. You'll see all this in a second. And basically give you a port that is also weatherproof to go out of your building. So here's a look at the first panel. They do slide between each other, but they lock in place. They have some sliding notches here. This is obviously the port that goes through and lets the stuff out of your room. You'll notice a hole right here. You put a bolt through here and it tightens along this T-track, which tightens it up. And in the event you have a window that is larger than this can cover, it comes with another panel and you can put it here and get some really wide width coverage. This will also work if you have windows that slide to open. This can all be mounted vertically as well. So this is pretty thick PVC. It's not some flimsy filling stuff and I've got some pretty high hopes for it. I did buy this myself. So that's probably something I should have said earlier. This is not sponsored in any way. I spent my money for this one, and this is what I chose to purchase after looking at all the options online. Okay, for assembly of the hardware, you've got a bolt with a large oval-shaped washer attached to it. That goes through the back, just like that. And then you want to put one washer, it's just a regular flat washer, and then a wing nut, but just barely start it. Something just like that. You want this flat washer down here floating enough because you now need to slide your panels back together and then also line up this flat washer to go inside the slot. So just like that. Then once you have it, that's what locks it in place, yet allows you to tighten the wing nut down and get your friction to lock things and keep it from sliding around. I think my window is to the size where I only need these two pieces, but I'm going to go ahead and use the other piece just so it gives me the cleanest look and so I don't lose my pieces. I think it will fit, and if so, that's great. I'll have a lower chance of losing it if I want to move this to a different window in the future. You will have to remove the window screen if you are installing this, unless you want to cut your screen, but in my opinion, that kind of negates the point of having the screen. So I've got to remove my window screen next, and then we'll start to put the pieces in the actual window frame. All right, make sure this is unlocked. Raise it up a little bit. Now I need to take the locks off the top to let my window panes slide inward because that's how this particular screen gets removed. Now that that is done, push this back to close. Go ahead and open it up some more. And now we can install our exhaust panel. All right, so I'm gonna put this inside my window track. You wanna put it where it should line up with some grooves on your window, or however you can get it to work with yours. And you wanna make sure that your panel in the middle doesn't block the circle. So definitely move it to the left, but otherwise you're gonna press this out and then you'll tighten your wing nuts after you put this piece into place. This is what connects to the inside. And if you notice, you may look at this and think, well, that's not gonna work. This has a lip around it to allow it to clear the bottom of your window trim. At least hopefully it works for you like it does for me. So this goes right into here and just snaps into place. Now we have full clearance. It's not sitting against the bottom of my window trim. That's great. I can attach my hose here. But now what I can do, pull this up tight, push these panels out left and right, and tighten down the wing nuts. Now what I'm going to install is this guy, and this particular item is what set this kit apart from others, at least whenever I bought this kit. This is an outdoor cover that goes on the other side of this hole through our, well, window trim, and this keeps the rain from coming in. The last thing I want is an exposed hose to just let wind blow rain in and me fill up my exhaust pipes with water. This simply goes outside and snaps and twist locks into place. I'll try and put the camera out there and hold it in a clear enough way to let you see it, but otherwise put it out there and twist it. It'll click and you'll know you got it. So you can see the outside of the piece, this guy right here. This has a flange and you want to just put it in and then twist until it locks in. May have to back it out a little bit, go to the right. And that's what you want to hear, the little clicks. You can feel the detents, they're in there, and you want to just pick one that has it level. Make sure your opening face is down. After that, you're good to go. Inside the kit, you get this silicone weather strip type thing. It looks like tape, but it's actually silicone strip, and it has an adhesive backing. I think that it's designed to go in this orientation, pointing up. So whenever you close your window, it kind of compresses and bends this to seal it. I say think because the instructions didn't say. I'm gonna go ahead and measure off this strip, cut it with some scissors, and apply it to this, and hopefully I'm doing it right. But if nothing else, hey, more Scotch tape can fix it, or duct tape, and it'll be okay. With the weather stripping installed, I'm just gonna pull the window down right up against that silicone and call it good for now. If this ends up being the permanent home of my UV printer, I will tape that up and seal it up more properly. But for now, this allows me to move on to the next step. My next step is to take my 4-inch inline duct fan that I also purchased from Amazon as a part of this build, mount it over here at the window so that I can then take my flexible 4-inch duct pipe, attach it to the fan, and also to the window port, and then from the incoming side of the fan to the eufyMake UV printer. In order to get access to these mounting screws on this plate, you gotta take these springs off and actually disconnect the inside of the fan. Just kind of push these back, slide them over, just like that. And then this side, you'll do the same thing. And so you're basically removing the motor from this assembly, mounting this piece, and then you'll put the motor back in. And then once you have that done, you can install your motor. This window kit did come with some aluminum flexible duct that does fit the window port, of course, and this inline fan, but I'm not going to use it because this stuff is notorious for getting small little pinholes in it. And then all you end up doing is just force feeding yourself back in your shop with your fumes. So that's why I'm not using this. But if you're in a pinch, in a pickle, it does come with the window kit. Not the fan, but the window kit. Instead, what I'll be doing is taking some of my flexible clear 4-inch PVC flex pipe, whatever this is, cutting a section off of it, putting it from the fan to the window, and then using what's left over to go from the fan to my UV printer. with our hose connected, the next thing we want to do is put it on the machine. But first, let me show you guys how to install my custom-made, custom-designed fume extractor on the eufyMake UV printer. And if you want one, which hopefully you do, I make them, produce them myself, and there's a link to them down below if you want to help me out, but also help yourself out by getting the stank fumes out of your space. This is how you install my fume extractor. You open the door, then run your fingers along this bottom edge and just pull this front panel off. This is held on with magnets, so you don't have to worry about damaging anything. You sit it down, set it aside, and here is your filter. Just take these little tabs, pull it forward, kind of work its way out. Be careful, this is cardboard, you don't want to bend it. What you have here is the actual exhaust port from the machine. Now you take the Samcraft fume extractor, which is designed to be a perfect fit with a nice matching gray color. All you do, put it into place, push it back until it stops, and you're done. Now you're ready to hook your hose up and get those stinky smells out of your shop. As I was designing this fume extraction system, I wanted to figure out the best place to put the hose to be as universally out of your way as possible. I initially started with a left or right configuration, but found that the flexible hose would droop down and get away with the door. But then as I would rotate my machine for the larger standard bed, it would get in the way, either running into my wall or poking out straight at me into my room. I decided to put it on the top. That way it's the most compact system possible. It keeps it out of the way. It does not interfere with your line of sight when you're looking in at the printer to get things in or out. It doesn't get in the way with your fingers to open and close that door. And you have easy access to the top of your machine for the start-stop button for jobs, for opening the top glass portion if you need to for maintenance, and also for replacing your ink cartridges. And just like that, we are done. Installation was a piece of cake. The hardest thing is probably mounting your duct fan and finding out where you want to put it. After that, the window trim is the second hardest. The hoses are the third, but by far the easiest part is this guy right here, the fume extractor. In all honesty, I've been using this in my shop for about a month now. And up until I'd had this, I had headaches every single day I was in my shop, whether or not I was printing. The UV resin stays in the machine. The odors stay. And while they do get filtered, and that probably does a lot, it still was enough to give me headaches, but also my wife and my kids. The really big telltale sign was when my son was out here one day, just for a short time, and then he had headaches later. At that point, I was like, okay, the headaches are not just me with allergies, it's gotta be this guy. So for the past month that I've had this on here, no one has had any headaches at all in the shop, which tells me this is crucial for the health and general well-being of all of us as we're around this machine. It's also worth saying that the eufyMake is not a just nasty machine. The process of UV resin printing, which is what this machine does, is naturally just vapor causing. It puts off vapors. So it's not that this machine was poorly built. It's not that this machine is poorly designed. It is just the way it is. Very similar to how laser engravers put off smells, smoke, and ugh when you cut or engrave. The same exact thing's happening here. You're doing some chemical processes. You're changing some things around, and it's just the way it goes. However, I am so glad to now have this done, but also show you guys, right? Since I do make and sell this as a part of income with some of the things that I make, I'm very happy to offer this to you. Hopefully you're able to get one if you are interested. And if nothing else, maybe you enjoyed hanging around the shop. Maybe that window adapter, if you have lasers, maybe that window adapter was worth it. I don't know, but I appreciate you being here all the same. If you got any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Otherwise, I'm about to jump into it and get back into printing town because I've got a full video coming on this guy very soon. Until then, take care. I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.